How to become a software architect. Let's learn with the Coder Therapist. To become a software architect, focus on gaining experience in the following areas. You need to really dive into the technical side, become a master of core programming languages, frameworks, and technologies. Get familiar with design patterns and start using them to tackle common problems. Focus on practicing system design to create scalable and maintainable solutions. Study and apply architectural principles like SOLID, microservices, and modularity to your projects. Get a good grasp of project management practices and methodologies like Agile and Scrum. Work on your soft skills, like communication, leadership, and negotiation. Improve your problem-solving skills and get better at making tough trade-offs. Keep learning and stay up to date with the latest industry trends, tools, and best practices. Hey, don't worry. I'm right here by your side, ready to help you achieve your dreams. Let's learn and grow together. Chapter 1, Software Architecture. Inside software architecture, we are going to learn Software Architecture Basic. How to create object-oriented design. Learn software design principles. Use design and modeling tools like UML. Microservices and event-driven design architecture. And many more. Chapter 2, Server-side technologies like Node.js, Python, C#, and others. Chapter 3, Front-end technologies. We will learn HTML5, CSS, JavaScript, TypeScript, frameworks like React.js, Angular.js, Next.js, and others. Chapter 4, DevOps. We are going to learn CI/CD, monitoring and logging. Chapter 5, Security, Performance, Scalability, when developing and maintaining an application/website, three crucial aspects to consider are security, performance, and scalability. Each plays a vital role in ensuring the site is safe, fast, and capable of handling growth. Chapter 6, Communication, Negotiation, Leadership. Communication, negotiation, and leadership are essential skills in both personal and professional settings. Each plays a critical role in how individuals interact, influence, and guide others. Software architecture is like a blueprint, but instead of designing a house, it's for creating software. It's the plan that shows how different parts of the software will work together. Imagine you're building a house. You need to decide where the rooms go, how they connect, and what materials to use. In software architecture, you do something similar. You figure out what parts the software needs, like databases or user interfaces, how they will talk to each other, and how information will move between. Let me show you the explanation along with a diagram to help you understand the application architecture. User interface layer. This is the top layer where users interact directly. It covers everything they see and use, like the user interface, UI, screens, or web pages. You can think of it as the front door of the software, where users come in and engage with the system. Application layer or business logic layer, or you can say service layer. This is the brain of the application, working quietly in the background. It takes what the user inputs through the UI, processes it, applies the business rules, and makes the necessary decisions. Think of it as the control center, managing the core operations of the software. Database layer. This is the storage layer, where all the data lives. It handles saving, retrieving, and managing everything. You can think of it as a big filing cabinet, keeping all the important information safe and ready to be accessed whenever you need it. The layers in a software architecture, like the user interface, UI layer, application layer, and database layer, are closely interconnected, each depending on the others to function properly. Here's how they work together. Face layer connection. When a user performs an action, like clicking a button, the UI layer sends that request to the application layer. Application layer or business logic connection. If the action requires data, the application layer communicates with the database layer to retrieve or store information. Once the data is processed, The application layer sends the results back to the UI layer to be displayed to the user. Database layer connection. It responds to requests from the application layer, providing the necessary data or confirming that an operation, like saving data, was successful. Thanks for watching The Coder Therapist. Do like and subscribe for more updates.